Think and Grow Rich for the Modern Reader, from the original unedited 1937 text by Napoleon Hill, an official production of the Napoleon Hill Foundation. I'm your narrator, Rich Germaine. This audiobook provides a synopsis of the original 1937 text of Hill's masterpiece, Think and Grow Rich. It extracts the key principles, instructions, and examples so that the modern professional, regardless of how busy he or she is, can benefit from the timeless wisdom found in Hill's book. To receive the greatest possible benefit from its wisdom, listen to one chapter per day, allowing the space and time to fully digest its insights and to enable your imaginative faculties to act on the thought impulses generated thereby. You will also undoubtedly find your progress magnified by working through this content in the setting of a book club or study group, wherein the mastermind principle can be applied to reach higher level orders of thinking. Regardless of your approach, when you commit yourself to practicing the steps outlined in this audiobook, you will surely open yourself up to great personal growth and momentum toward achieving your dreams. Whatever the mind can conceive and believe, the mind can achieve. Napoleon Hill. This audiobook provides a synopsis of the original 1937 text of Hill's masterpiece, Think and Grow Rich. It extracts the key principles, instructions, and examples so that the modern professional, regardless of how busy he or she is, can benefit from the timeless wisdom found in Hill's book. To receive the greatest possible benefit from its wisdom, listen to one chapter per day, allowing the space and time to fully digest its insights and to enable your imaginative faculties to act on the thought impulses generated thereby. You will also undoubtedly find your progress magnified by working through this content in the setting of a book club or study group, wherein the mastermind principle can be applied to reach higher level orders of thinking. Regardless of your approach, when you commit yourself to practicing the steps outlined in this audiobook, you will surely open yourself up to great personal growth and momentum toward achieving your dreams. Whatever the mind can conceive and believe, the mind can achieve. Napoleon Hill. Publisher's Preface. This book conveys the experience of more than 500 men of great wealth who began at scratch with nothing to give in return for riches except thoughts, ideas, and organized plans. Here you have the entire philosophy of money-making, just as it was organized from the actual achievements of the most successful men known to the American people during the past 50 years. It describes what to do, also how to do it. It provides you with a perfect system of self-analysis that will readily disclose what has been standing between you and the big money in the past. It describes the famous Andrew Carnegie formula of personal achievement by which he accumulated hundreds of millions of dollars for himself and made no fewer than a score of millionaires of men to whom he taught his secret. It was written by the man to whom Carnegie disclosed the astounding secret of his riches, the same man to whom the 500 wealthy men revealed the source of their riches. In this volume will be found the 13 principles of money-making essential to every person who accumulates sufficient money to guarantee financial independence. Money and material things are essential for freedom of body and mind. But there are some who will feel that the greatest of all riches can be evaluated only in terms of lasting friendships, harmonious family relationships, sympathy and understanding between business associates, and introspective harmony, which brings one peace of mind measurable only in spiritual values. All who read, understand, and apply this philosophy will be better prepared to attract and enjoy these higher estates, which always have been and always will be denied to all except those who are ready for them. Be prepared, therefore, when you expose yourself to the influence of this philosophy, to experience a changed life, which may help you not only to negotiate your way through life with harmony and understanding, but also to prepare you for the accumulation of material riches in abundance. Author's Preface. In every chapter of this book, mention has been made of the money-making secret which has made fortunes for more than 500 exceedingly wealthy men whom I have carefully analyzed over a long period of years. The secret was brought to my attention by Andrew Carnegie more than a quarter of a century ago. The canny, lovable old Scotsman carelessly tossed it into my mind when I was but a boy. Then he sat back in his chair with a merry twinkle in his eyes and watched carefully to see if I had brains enough to understand the full significance of what he had said to me. When he saw that I had grasped the idea, he asked if I would be willing to spend 20 years or more preparing myself to take it to the world, to men and women who, without the secret, might go through life as failures. I said I would. And with Mr. Carnegie's cooperation, I have kept my promise. This book contains the secret, after having been put to a practical test by thousands of people in almost every walk of life. It was Mr. Carnegie's idea that the magic formula, which gave him a stupendous fortune, ought to be placed within reach of people who do not have time to investigate how men make money, and it was his hope that I might test and demonstrate the soundness of the formula through the experience of men and women in every calling. The secret to which I refer has been mentioned no fewer than 100 times throughout this book. It has not been directly named, for it seems to work more successfully when it is merely uncovered and left in sight, where those who are ready and searching for it may pick it up. That is why Mr. Carnegie tossed it to me so quietly, without giving me its specific name. If you are ready to put it to use, you will recognize this secret at least once in every chapter. I wish I might feel privileged to tell you how you will know if you are ready, but that would deprive you of much of the benefit you will receive when you make the discovery in your own way. A peculiar thing about this secret is that those who once acquire it and use it find themselves literally swept on to success with but little effort, and they never again submit to failure. The secret to which I refer cannot be had without a price, although the price is far less than its value. It cannot be had at any price by those who are not intentionally searching for it. It cannot be given away. It cannot be purchased for money, for the reason that it comes in two parts. One part is already in possession of those who are ready for it. The secret serves equally well all who are ready for it. Education has nothing to do with it. I've never known anyone who was inspired to use the secret who did not achieve noteworthy success in his chosen calling. I have never known any person to distinguish himself or to accumulate riches of any consequence without possession of the secret. From these two facts, I draw the conclusion that the secret is more important as part of the knowledge essential for self-determination than any which one receives through what is popularly known as education. As far as schooling is concerned, many of these men had very little. Henry Ford never reached high school, let alone college. I'm not attempting to minimize the value of schooling, but I'm trying to express my earnest belief that those who master and apply the secret will reach high stations, will accumulate riches, and bargain with life on their own terms, even if their schooling has been meager. Somewhere, as you read, the secret to which I refer will jump from the page and stand boldly before you, if you are ready for it. When it appears, you will recognize it. Whether you receive the sign in the first or the last chapter, stop for a moment when it presents itself and turn down a glass, for that occasion will mark the most important turning point of your life. As a final word of preparation before you begin the first chapter, may I offer one brief suggestion which may provide a clue by which the Carnegie secret may be recognized? It is this: all achievement, all earned riches, have their beginning in an idea.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.